afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the third annual SJA Jeju High School Commencement Ceremony. I'm Corey Johnson, the SJA Jeju High School Principal. This afternoon, we have several honored dignitaries with us on the stage. Dr. Jeannie Sung, Head of School, Mr. Justin Boyd, High School Assistant Principal, Ms. Catherine Grzynski, High School Dean of Students, Mr. Matt Leishman, Middle School Principal, Mr. Doug Jolly, Director of Residential Life, Mr. Michael Fisher, Director of Teaching and Learning, Mr. David Griffith, Director of Technology, Mr. Eric Moss, Director of Athletics, and Mr. Edward Gonzalez, High School Filmmaking Teacher and Faculty Speaker. Let's give our honored dignitaries a round of applause. I would also like to recognize the members of the SJA Jeju Board of Trustees who are present for graduation. Ms. Kelly Herr, Mr. Jack Cummings, and Mr. Bruce Buxton. Let's give our honored guests a round of applause. Please join me now and kindly stand up as we welcome the procession of SJA Jeju's Class of 2022. Thank you, everyone. Please be seated. First, let me congratulate the class of 2022. You have successfully negotiated your way through school. Congratulations. This is a great day for all of you. Appropriately, at this time, I'd like to thank the teachers, faculty, and staff. All of you have worked very hard to educate and support our graduates. Teachers spend many extra hours going above and beyond what they are paid just to find that extra help that they can give each student. They are a group of professionals that truly care about the success of each of our students. Let's have a round of applause for our teachers, faculty, and staff. I would also like to thank the parents and volunteers who make our lives so much easier with their willingness to help with school life and school events. In addition, I would like to thank each of the parents for trusting SJA Jeju with their students' future and the great support they've given the school from the foundation of the school until now. Graduates, please join me in a much-deserved round of applause for your parents. We all have so much to be proud of with the class of 2022, and you, their loving parents, have much to celebrate on this exciting occasion and very important milestone in the lives of your children. In keeping with the tradition of SJA Jeju, each senior class invites a member of the faculty to speak at graduation. This honor is selected by the senior class for a teacher they felt made a major impact on their lives and has been a positive role model for their success. The class of 2022 faculty speaker is Mr. Edward Gonzalez. Please give a round of applause and welcome Mr. Gonzalez to the podium.
Good afternoon, fellow teachers, school leaders, families, and the amazing graduating class of 2022. Not long ago, when starting to write this speech, I was feeling the pressure of this assignment. It would be our last message to students, and I worried that some of you might fall asleep. Not that you have ever fallen asleep in class or assembly before. But this was not the best way to think about this speech. I was focusing on the pressure and what others will think of it, so I changed my mindset about the speech. I chose to view it as an honor and an opportunity, representing all of our voices, teachers and administrators, in wishing you a farewell, our last goodbye, in our last message. Today, I'd like to talk to you about mindsets, our values, and when bad things come knocking at the door. As teachers, on special days like today, we are joyous and we're proud. Some of us even carry a tissue or two in our pockets in case we tear up. But there is a voice in us that wonders a little bit, did we prepare you to face the problems you will face? Did we prepare you to be strong when life gets tough? When you encounter difficult emotions or moments of disappointment or fear? Moments that will test your character? We did, but not entirely. Not because we did not try, but because of the nature of problems. Problems are complex and unique in their own ways. But mindsets can help deal with these uninvited guests. Mindsets, the ways you interpret the things that happen to you. Often, when you change the way you think about something, it can lead to positive change. I used to be awful at basketball. I still am. But that's beside the point. I was so bad that I stopped playing basketball when I was a teenager. Last summer, however, I decided to challenge myself and do something outside of my comfort zone and learn basketball. I have been practicing every week since then. I went from looking like a wobbly, wandering cluster of ramen noodles to a less wobbly one. I'm still learning, but the point is that I changed my mindset about basketball, and I now enjoy it. What is worthwhile isn't the end result of knowing how to play, but it is the joy of the process. But what about real problems? In life, you will experience sadness, but with some reflection, you can turn the sadness into a lesson that teaches you to cherish moments of joy. You will experience anxiety because instead of writing your English essay, you decided to play League of Legends all night long. This anxiety can teach you to prioritize. You might experience loneliness. Use it to learn to value time with families and friends. Feeling ignored and excluded could teach you to treat others with compassion. Rejection can turn into self-awareness. This is the power of your mindset. I have to tell you, students, fulfillment, happiness, and achievement do not come from a rosy, perfect life with no problems. They often come from overcoming challenges and reframing how you view them. If a pianist has a hand injury and cannot play the piano professionally for the rest of her life, mindsets are not going to change the fact that she cannot fulfill her dream of becoming a professional pianist. But a productive mindset can be the difference between despair and determination. It affects how we respond to unexpected situations. Whether we realize it or not, we're always choosing how to think about the things that happen to us. In turn, we're always choosing the values by which we live our lives. When many of you took the time to greet your teachers and thank them for the day's lesson, you saw that as the nice thing to do. You were guided by the values of kindness and respect. Or the day you stopped being afraid of Mr. Boyd, you chose the value of open-mindedness. Or the day you chose to dress up as a caveman for a history project and call yourself Monkey Boy. You chose courage and humor. It was hilarious. Or the day you supported each other after losing an important soccer game. You chose sportsmanship and community. Now, values like greed, laziness, pleasure for the sake of pleasure, or trying to succeed to be more successful than others, hurt your character, and they are socially destructive. Good values, on the other hand, such as humility, self-respect, courage, being a good friend, and being honest, create healthy and constructive ways of thinking about the world. Which values do you think will guide your mindset in the future? When you accept responsibility for your character, for your actions, and for everything in your control, you empower yourself. You are saying, "This is the kind of person who I want to be." The pianist with a hand injury can drown in the disappointment of it all. Or they can choose to empower themselves. They can say, "I have cried a good amount of tears. I must move on and seek other dreams." Let me tie all this together in a nice little knot. Good values and productive mindsets will not prevent your problems, but they will help you deal with them in ways you can be proud of. As you move into your future, think about a few of the positive values you learned at your time here at SJA Jeju and choose to live by them. Spend time thinking about who you want to be. This will strengthen your resolve when a challenge emerges. As values will shape your mindsets, and mindsets will shape your response. And your character will shine with charisma and purpose. Okay, now it is time for a little homework. You have to write a 2-page essay, MLA format, on the relationship between mindsets and values. Oh, wait, no more homework? I can't assign them more essays? They're free? Okay, you've earned it. Graduating class of 2022, we are so excited for you. Your next years in life will be filled with discoveries about yourself and about the world around you. Make sure to take care of yourselves. Be your strongest ally. Laugh often. Eat healthy. Make friends with people who want the best for you. Speak honestly. Accept that time is precious and use it wisely. Teach yourself something new every now and then. When you're bored, make a movie. Be goofy whenever necessary. And know that no matter what, you will be okay. On behalf of the teachers, staff, and administrators at SJA Jeju, we will keep you in our hearts and our minds. We are so proud of you. Graduating class of 2022, congratulations. Please welcome Mr. Johnson back to the podium.
Wonderful. Thank you, Mr. Gonzalez, for your inspirational and uplifting message. Let's give one more big round of applause for Mr. Gonzalez. To our graduates as individuals, I would like to say the following. You're a hardworking, dedicated group who has thoroughly deserved your success. As a class, I've noticed how helpful you are to each other and how willing you are to support the teachers and the school. You faced many challenges along the way, but you persevered, showing moxie, true grit, and determination. You're an outstanding group of students, and I'm very proud of each and every one of you. But for a moment, let's take a trip back in time. Let me take you back to that first scary day when you walked through the gates of our school. You may have thought at the moment that your teachers and administrators laid out detailed plans for you. Hardworking teachers monitored everything you did. You're given homework, timetables, mentors, prescribed reading and term papers. It must have seemed like you had no time you controlled for yourself. Life was very busy and very structured. However, as you progressed through grade 9, grade 10, and grade 11, we tried to move back a little and ensure that you knew what was required, but had the increasing levels of autonomy in your classes and choices and decisions. Your choices began to determine your direction. Maybe you've wondered about this from time to time or reflected why we do this. And the reason for this is simple. You must create your future through your choices. And every decision you make leads you down the path to the person that you will become. Our lives are built on the choices that we make. Every choice is a turning point that creates the mosaic of our lives. So I hope you make good choices and are true to who you are and what you believe. Remember, awards and accolades are great, but they do not define you. Define yourself every day through the strength of your character and the quality of your character. So, as you'll notice, some of our students on the stage have medallions. These medallions are given to students that have been at the school since our founding year. If you are one of these students, please stand and be recognized for your pioneering contribution to SJA Jeju. Thank you. Please be seated. As we celebrate you all today, it's my distinct pleasure as your high school principal to discuss our students' honor regalia and present several awards to our graduates. These honor regalia and awards will be given on an annual basis at every graduation ceremony at SJA Jeju moving forward. As our graduates entered the auditorium, you may have noticed that some students will be wearing green and white honor cords. These cords were given to students as a tangible recognition of their commitment to AP courses. Each student with a green and white honor cord successfully completed 5 or more AP classes at SJA Jeju. Students, please stand and be recognized for your efforts and achievements. Antonia Sofia Amat Poblete. Yumin Cha. Yiji Chin. Ethan Choi. Jae Yoon Jeon. Min Sok Kim. Tae Woo Kim. Ji Hong Lee. Tan Lee. Sung-un Moon. Ryan Park. Siyun Park. Young Ho Park. Let's give a big round of applause to these students. Thank you. Please be seated. Five of our graduates were also awarded Tangerine Honor Cords. These cords symbolize outstanding effort and achievement on their senior capstone projects. These five students generated thoughtful, sophisticated essays, innovative and meaningful projects, and presentations that stood out well above the rest. Students, please stand and be recognized for your efforts. Antonia Sofia Amat Poblete. Hyunmin Cha. Brian Moon. Sia Kim. Siyun Park. Let's give a big round of applause for these students. Thank you. Please be seated. Next, I'd like to take a moment to talk about National Honor Society. National Honor Society members are wearing white stoles in recognition of their commitment to the ideals of scholarship, service, leadership, and character. For the 2021-22 school year, NHS members have demonstrated positive leadership characters while collectively giving over 400 hours of service to both the school and community. Examples of service include running a peer learning support center, supporting elementary school students in after-school activities, and serving as translators at school events. NHS would not be able to run effectively without the exemplary work of our officers. Officers, please stand and be recognized. President Antonia Sofia Amat Poblete. Treasurer E.G. Chin. Historian Sia Kim. NHS members, also please stand and be recognized. Hyunmin Cha. Jaeyoung Jung. Jaehong Lee. Jihong Lee. Let's give a big round of applause to the NHS students. Thank you. Please be seated. I'd like to next talk about our awards for today. The first award we're going to give is called the High School Principal Award. This annual award is presented to students in the senior class who best embody the spirit of SJA Jeju's High School through their scholarship, contributions to the high school community, and their spirit of collegiality and kindness that they bring to our high school every day. I'm proud to announce the recipients of the High School Principal Award for the class of 2022. Mr. Hyunmin Cha. And Mr. Sung Jun Han. Our next award is the Homer Hobert Award. It's named after our distinguished St. Johnsbury Academy alumnus from the class of 1880. Mr. Hobert is buried in Seoul's Wonjongjin Cemetery for his dedication to his life's work to Korea and the Korean language. Mr. Hobert first traveled to Korea in 1886 as an English teacher. This award is presented to the graduating senior who best embodies the spirit of SJA's distinguished graduate, Homer Hobert. The recipient embodies the passion of discovery, education, and mutual respect between the United States and Korea, to which Mr. Hobart dedicated his life's work. This senior epitomizes the ongoing friendly and positive relationship between the two countries of St. Johnsbury Academy. I'm proud to announce the winner of the Homer Hobart Award from the class of 22, Ms. Sia Kim. Our final award before our academic achievement awards is the annual award that we've created based on our important mission of character, inquiry, and community. This annual award is presented to the senior who best represents the ideals and goals of our school's mission. This student has demonstrated the highest levels of character. She is known for her academic curiosity and success. And she is a student that has stood out for her positive contributions to a caring and maintaining a friendly, warm and caring atmosphere here at SJA Jeju. I'm proud to announce the winner of the Character, Inquiry, and Community Award from the class of 2022, Ms. Antonia Sofia Amat Poblete. At this time, I'd like to recognize our salutatorian, the student in the class of 2022 with the second highest GPA. Please join me in welcoming and recognizing the class of 2022's salutatorian, Ms. E.G. Chin. Finally, for our last award, we will recognize our valedictorian, the student in the class of 2022 with the highest cumulative GPA from this distinguished group of graduates. Every once in a while in education, you meet a student that is truly exceptional, a student with the strength of character, determination of purpose, and a strong will to support themselves and their classmates to meet their goals and be successful in school. When you spend time with this student, her honest, transparent approach is evident in everything she does. Underneath her humble, unassuming personality beats the heart of a true leader. With this student, you simply know that she will approach every situation from the lens of what is best for the school, and that resonates and speaks volumes about the kind of person that she is and what she values. Kindly join me in applause in welcoming the class of 2022's valedictorian to our podium, Ms. Seon Park.
Good afternoon, fellow graduating students, teachers, and parents. Thank you for coming all the way from the mainland or from the city to celebrate our last day in high school. On this day that will be remembered forever, I want to emphasize two properties that led us to success: commitment and choice. You may be wondering what is so special about commitment. Well, commitment can be defined as a very simple task. You can be committed to sign up for courses. You can be committed to applying to universities. You can be committed to attend the graduation ceremony. In other words, regardless of the difficulty or simplicity, the series of commitment that you have shown have meaningfully accumulated over time. they have stacked up layer by layer, whether it be experience, joy, or skill. Then they defined who you are now and how you have changed. You all have determined your next destination for your own future. And whatever you do after graduation, it is a success because it is an assembly of your own commitments. Next property, I believe that took us all to success is the choice we made in diverse stages of high school life. Of course, these choices may have been challenging, and it is natural since high school has been an endless trip of asking questions. Will AP chemistry or statistics be too difficult to study? What responsibility will we hold while participating in clubs? How are we going to figure out if the choice we make is the right choice? I personally always questioned my choice. I can still remember my sophomore self anxiously standing in front of Mr. Boy's office trying to fix my schedule until the very last minute. However, it is not how grand the outcome is that I want to congratulate. I want to recognize all of you for just making that choice, the confidence and the effort you invested, and the experience you got. High school can be daunting, and it rarely leaves you a place to hide or run away. So setting a foot on the stairs, a hand on the doors, and fingers on the keyboard is something that indicates that we have made it through a meaningful yet challenging mission in our lifetime. It is unambiguously valuable for us to celebrate. You might sometimes feel like your choices led you to temporary failures or setbacks, but still, keep running at your own pace and choose whatever your heart leads to. All of your choices matter, and they are meaningful no matter what, since you have made it this far with responsibility. Therefore, I sincerely long for your journey and courage to continue for whatever you aim for. Thank you.
Fantastic speech, Seun. You're an inspiration to your class, and we know you have a very bright future ahead of you. Let's give one more round of applause to Seun for her speech. I would now like to welcome the high school band, led by Mr. Moy. The band will be playing a song composed by 12th grade student E.G. Chin, the SJA Jeju alma mater, inspired by the alma mater from St. Johnsbury Academy in Vermont. Thank you, Mr. Moy and the high school band. We appreciate your talents in helping us to commemorate this special day. Let's give one more big round of applause to Mr. Moy and the band. In a moment, we'll award the diplomas. It's what we've gathered here to witness, your son, your daughter, your student, walking across the stage with their diploma in hand. It is St. Johnsbury Academy Jeju's tradition to invite the advisory teachers from each senior class group to come to the podium to call out their students' names individually and give them the well-deserved opportunity to walk across the stage and receive their high school diploma. It is a joyous occasion, but one that calls for proper respect and decorum, which appropriately reflects the importance of this significant milestone in the lives of these graduates. So on behalf of the graduates and St. Johnsbury Academy Jeju, I ask you to join me in giving each of these fantastic students their moment. Let's wait to celebrate loudly until all names have been called so that their families and friends can hear the name of each graduate as they receive their diplomas. Distinguished guests. Please welcome Ms. Dragana Babic to the podium.
Will my advisees please stand up? Hyun Min Cha. Jung Young Cho. Sung Jun Han. Hyung Woo Kim. Young Do Kim. Sun Jae Kwon. Dong Hyun Lee. Jae Hong Lee. Ji Hong Lee. Song Un Moon. Thank you. Please welcome Miss Christine Emerson to the podium.
Will my advisees please stand up? Ethan Choi. Mm-hmm. Soyeon Oh. Soonhyun Hwang. Soyoung Jung. Sia Kim. Sungwoo Lee. Taeyeon Lee. Brian Moon. Ryan Park. Young Ho Park. Thank you. Please welcome Mr. Zach Fromey to the stage.
Will my advisees please stand up? Antonia Sophia Amet Poblete. Unsa Cho. Min Sa Kim. Yeonjun Kim. Min Sak Kwon. Jung-un Lee. Celine Park. Seun Park. Alicia Watson. Thank you. Please welcome Mr. Edward Gonzalez back to the podium.
With my advisees, please stand up. Yiji Chen. Wan Sok Hong. Jaeyun Jung. Jimin Kang. Song Meng Kang. Horim Kim. Taeuk Kim. Youngun Kim. Yibin Park. Moonjoon Pei. Anthony Song. Thank you. Please welcome Ms. Sunny Hu to the podium.
Will my advisees please stand up? Kenu Choi. Zhe Chu. Xinhui Ha. Sanju Han. Taun Zhong. So Young Jin. Janet Kwan. Yelim Lee. Zubin Lee. Soohyang Park. Dong Hee Yun. Thank you. Please welcome Dr. Song to the podium.
Good afternoon, class of 2022. First, I would like to begin by thanking your parents and teachers who supported you along the way and are so proud of you. Without their tireless efforts, none of this would be possible. Thank you, parents and staff, for all you've done in support of our graduates. We are so grateful to be able to have you join us in person in this year's graduation ceremony. Graduates, I am so proud of you and incredibly honored to be part of your special day today. I hope you all know how exceptional you are and just how much you have to offer this world. During a terrible global pandemic, you navigated through challenging classes and maybe even more challenges outside the classrooms. We applaud and recognize your unwavering hard work and all the hidden struggles and hardships you had to work through and overcome. I am honored to have witnessed your amazing journey during our time here at SJA Jeju. You've truly earned this moment. As you set out to continue on your lifelong journey, Be proud of who you are. You are powerful. You are resilient. You are compassionate. You are leaders. You are the ones who will shape this world for the better. So continue to be bold and courageous. Be proud of who you are and what you've already accomplished. Know that you will always have so many people who love and care for you. We will be the wind at your back as you set out to start your new adventure and change the world. Graduates, please stand. You may now transfer your tassels from the right side to the left side to symbolize your crossing from high school to the next stage in your lives. Dear parents, dignitaries, and teachers, I now present to you the St. John's Beer Academy Jeju Class of 2022! Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, please remain seated until our graduates and dignitaries have left the auditorium. On your way out of the auditorium, please return your headsets to the containers at the back of the auditorium. Thank you for being here today.
SJA Jeju's graduation ceremony. Please return.
Maestro, music. We need music, please. Da 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 da. Technical difficulties. All right, we will start the procession. Ready, set, go. Exit. Thank you very much. There we go.
Have I done my best here? Or will I be here next year? Or are these my best years yet? Was looking forward to being important, but I'm not important yet.
If you would just see my lonely screen, is a cold and happy end. If the world gets me where I'm supposed to be, will I know I've made it then? It's so hard.
Can we skip to the good part? If there's a good part, then I hope it's not far, 'cause I thought it'd be today. I napped on campus and I smoked at dances, but it didn't feel so great.
If you put this scene on a movie screen, is a cold or happy end? If the world gets me where I'm supposed to be, will I know I've made it then? It's so hard.
So can we skip to the good part? perfect time. Mom and dad, they have a good life. But what am I gonna do with mine? These things take time. Mom and dad, they have a good life. But what the hell am I gonna do with mine?